Hello, I'm Jeanette Holland Austin, and I would like to tell you a story of the Battle of King's Mountain that was fought in October of 1780. There's a very interesting tale of a British lieutenant colonel by the name of Patrick Ferguson. Ferguson was a rather arrogant military officer, and just several years earlier, he had invented a breech rifle, which was being used by the British Army. Well, he had a plan to defeat the Americans, and so he sent a dispatch to Lord Cornwallis, and this is what he said: "My Lord, I am on my march to you by a road leading from Cherokee Ford north of King's Mountain. 300 or 400 good soldiers would finish this business. Something must be done soon, Patrick Ferguson." Well, instead of Ferguson waiting for a reply from Lord Cornwallis, he forged ahead. And it is said that his pride outweighed his better judgment. He moved his troops in the direction of Yorkville, South Carolina, and on this road, after crossing a creek, came to King's Mountain in the afternoon, and it's there that he pitched camp. He had selected the ground that he defied God Almighty and the rebels out of hell to overcome him. So now Ferguson's plan was for his troops to charge down upon the American soldiers as they approached the foot of King's Mountain. Well, early that morning, there had been a rain, and the American soldiers had headed toward the foot of the mountain in this rain. Well, by the time they got there, the rain had increased and it was very misty. So the over the mountain men, they were temporarily lost in the woods. Well, here is the story here. The Americans were out for revenge against Colonel Bonasta Tarleton. The reason was that at Waxhaws, a white flag had been driven up because the Americans wanted to surrender. They did not have enough troops to fight Tarleton's army. But Tarleton gave them no quarter. Instead, he ran the soldiers through with his swords. This news got back to all of the militia companies in South Carolina and Georgia, the troops, and they became determined to get revenge. So here's what was happening. The Americans were joining up with the regiments all throughout South Carolina. They were meeting up with the army and joining in for the fight. Also, the over the mountain men, these were the men who had gone west with their families and traveled in the wilderness country in the mountains, the Allegheny Mountains and the Blue Ridge Mountains, and they were good hunters. They carried in their arms the bluster gun, and the long rifle. And they were good soldiers. So as the rain cleared up that morning, the battle began. Ferguson's men came charging down upon the Americans, but the battle ended in less than 2 hours. It was this battle at King's Mountain that determined the final fate of the war. After that, the Americans went on to win several battles in South Carolina, then into North Carolina, and finally into Yorktown. I hope that you are interested in finding some of your ancestors who fought in this interesting battle. For truly, this is a great experience to learn about the bravery of our soldiers.